Hello, everyone, and welcome to the November 2025 Sky Report. My name is Vanessa, and I'm joined today by Patrick.
Hi, stargazers.
Let's see what's happening in the skies this month.
Comet C2025A6 Lemmon is visible in our sky in the evening now, right after sunset. The most recent observations of the comet's brightness indicate that it is unlikely to be visible without a telescope or binoculars, especially from our light-polluted location in Los Angeles. However, the brightness of a comet is difficult to predict. The best view will always be from a dark sky site with a low western horizon.
Remember to set your clocks back 1 hour when daylight saving time ends on November 2nd, which leads to earlier sunsets in the evening.
On November 7th, we will observe another northern standstill moonrise. The moon will rise as far north as is possible for the moon and follow a path higher than that of the summer solstice sun. Moonrise will occur at around 6:48 p.m. Pacific Standard Time and will be very close to the star Alnath in Taurus. Rise time is very dependent on your location and your local horizon. You don't need any special equipment to watch this event, and there are many ways to watch. You may note the moon's location on your horizon at rise time, as described here, and then compare it to other days. You may look at where the moon is in the sky compared to stars and constellations and make note of that and compare it to other times of the year. You may also watch where the moon sets on your horizon. It is possible to note the moon's extreme position from any of these observations, so don't worry if you miss the rise time. Here at Griffith Observatory, we have observed this event with all three of these methods, but also with a unique building instrument called the Meridian Arc in the Gottlieb Transit Corridor. You may find more details about the nature of the lunar standstill season by watching our series of lunar standstill broadcasts on YouTube.
The peak of the Leonid meteor shower will occur on the night of the 16th to the morning of the 17th, with an expected rate of 10 meteors per hour under a clear dark sky. The moon, a 10% waning crescent, will have no impact on the viewing conditions. Looking east at 10 p.m., you can see the entire winter constellation group. Leading the way is the Pleiades star cluster, best viewed with binoculars. Below it lies Taurus the Bull with its bright orange star Aldebaran. Next to Taurus is Auriga with a bright yellow star Capella. Below Taurus, you'll find Orion the Hunter, marked by its bright stars Betelgeuse and Rigel, along with three stars in a row that forms the Hunter's Belt. Gemini the Twins is next to Orion with its bright stars Castor and Pollux. Directly below them shines the brilliant planet Jupiter.
Looking south, we do not see many bright stars this time of year. Higher in the south, we can see the faint constellation Pisces, and far below it near the horizon is Pisces Austrinus with the lonely bright star Fomalo.
To the west, the stars of the summer triangle, Deneb, Altair, and Vega, dip low towards the northwest horizon by 10 p.m. The Northern Cross, an asterism in Cygnus the Swan, is made up of five bright stars that form a cross-like shape in the sky, and as it nears the horizon in Southern California, it appears to be standing upright. Meanwhile, above the summer triangle, Pegasus begins to take center stage in the western sky. Jupiter rises around 9 p.m. in mid-month and is well placed for observation, remaining visible throughout the night. On the 9th, the waning gibbous moon will be about 3.5 degrees from Jupiter, located in the constellation Gemini below the twins' brightest stars, Castor and Pollux.
This month, Saturn stays between the constellations of Pisces and Aquarius all month. The planet is visible as the night begins and stays in the sky until about 2 a.m. The planet will be one of the very few bright objects in this part of the sky. And here is your lunar calendar for this month. The full moon is on the 5th. The last quarter is on the 11th. The new moon is on the 19th. And the first quarter is on the 27th.
That's all we have for November. We'll see you again next month. Bye.
Bye.